be on the swing. So in order to do that, decided to use the energy lens to figure out the potential energy plus work in order to get to your final potential energy. All right, so we started with the stone casties at the initial height, and then in this drawing, I pull her up. This is when I pull her up to push her back down, and we calculated with tracker that that was a height of 0.23 meters. So then our after I pushed her down, her final height, which we figured out from tracker, is 0.47 meters. So using all of that, we're going to calculate the force that, or the work that I pushed her with, using force in the positive direction that way.
Okay, so for our physics project, we're calculating the force in this direction that Jackie put on Cassie on the swing after lifting her up and pushing on her. And we're also calculating the velocity right here at the bottom of the swing. So we're doing this through the energy lens. So using conservation of energy, we are finding this initial potential energy that Cassie has when Jackie lifted her up on the swing. And that is going to equal, so energy is conserved, so that's going to equal the final potential energy plus the work that, so the initial potential energy plus the work that Jackie puts in by pushing her is going to equal the final potential energy, which turns into kinetic energy down here at the bottom and then turns back into potential energy at the top, but we can just ignore the potential energy in the middle. So our first calculation was this initial potential energy right here at a height of 0.23 meters. So we did this by calculating Cassie's mass times the acceleration due to gravity times the height that she was lifted up to, which is 151 joules of potential energy. So just theoretically, if Jackie were to have let go of Cassie right here and not pushed her at all, then this would have been converted directly into kinetic energy, and she would have had a speed of 2.4 meters per second right here at the bottom, and then she would have gone on to have the same height if she had just been let go, but she wasn't. So we know that her final height was 0.47 meters, so we know that her final potential energy was about 309 joules of energy. And using this potential energy, we know that the kinetic energy in the bottom is going to be equal to that, so we know that the velocity that she had at the bottom right here was 3 meters per second about. In order to find the work and force that Jackie did on Cassie, we know that energy is conserved, so we know that this original potential energy plus the work that Jackie did on Cassie is going to equal the final potential energy right here. So we plug in these values that we found right here, and we get that Jackie put in about 158 joules of work on Cassie. And we know that work equals force times distance, and we know that the distance that Jackie was pushing on Cassie was 0.526 meters, and we found this out from tracker, just like we found these two heights. So we know that this distance that she was pushing on her before she let go was 0.526 meters. So we can plug that in to this, and we get that the force over this distance was about 300 newtons on Cassie.